Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, my name is the Ripper Danny B, and welcome back to another episode of CWR Asylum, coming to you tonight from Long Beach, California. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome one half of the World Tag Team Champions, John Cena! Cena has requested a spot tonight. He says he has something he wants to say. Cena is here alone tonight on Asylum as well. Randy Orton is already in the United Kingdom doing promotional work for the upcoming Imperial Anarchy pay-per-view, which will be taking place this Sunday, live from London, England. So John Cena here on his own tonight. Now, Cena and Orton do not have opponents for Imperial Anarchy as we speak. And you know, Mr. Hustle, Loyalty, Respect, Mr. Pay-per-View himself is not going to want to miss that show. Cena tonight, showing off that World Tag Team belt that he is ever so proud of. Defended them successfully against Ascension at Night of Champions, but tonight, Cena has something to say. There you have it. John Cena has made the challenge to Conor and Victor of the Ascension to give them another shot at the World Tag Team Championships at Imperial Anarchy. But this is neither Conor nor Victor. This is The Miz. As always, well, you know Miz is going to talk when he's out here. It's a given. Well, there you have it. John Cena said, I'll fight you tonight if you want to fight Miz. Miz says, nah, not tonight. And then Big Show appeared on the Tron to say, actually, yeah, you will. That will be our main event tonight. But we've got to move on now to the following contest. And this competition is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, Heath Slater, baby! I say this every time Slater comes out here because it's still true. Heath Slater is desperate to try and get himself climbing up that ladder one more time. This was a man that when CWR first came to be, very nearly became the inaugural CWR World Heavyweight Champion. Could you imagine? Heath Slater has been slipping further and further down the rungs of the ladder ever since that day. Over a year ago at Money in the Bank, the original Money in the Bank 2016. Tonight, Heath Slater, with this match, could turn that all around with one huge upset victory. Heath Slater's opponent this evening He is the CWR World Heavyweight Champion, the Eater of Worlds, Bray Wyatt. We know that Bray Wyatt will have a defense against Sheamus at Imperial Anarchy this Sunday. Now again, Sheamus, just like Randy Orton, is not here this evening in Long Beach. He is in the UK already. Some of the talents have gone over early for promotional work for the upcoming pay-per-view, and for a multitude of other reasons, but Sheamus is one of those talents that is not here. So Bray Wyatt can come out here safe in the knowledge that Sheamus isn't going to appear and attempt to kick his head off. Bray Wyatt can instead focus on this match this evening and focus on asserting dominance and building momentum heading towards that championship match with the former two-time champion, the Celtic Warrior, the pay-per-view. You have Heath Slater there, Bray Wyatt. Let's not mess around, let's get this thing on. The bell has rung. And we've got a tie up here in the middle of the ring. Now this is very interesting. Neither one of these two realistically are good technical wrestlers. You wouldn't expect that from them. Heath Slater has a very hybrid offense. Bray Wyatt certainly relies on his power and his shot value. Look at that there, big running crossbody from the Eater of Worlds. Straight away, Bray Wyatt playing mind games with Slater. Look at that, luring Heath Slater in before clobbering him with that massive clothesline. And the World Heavyweight Champion has taken control of this match pretty much immediately. There is nothing that can scare the Eater of Worlds. You can hear the crowd. Bray is gonna kill you. No faith for Heath Slater this evening. And the one-man rock band cannot be very happy with that kind of attitude. But Bray says he is the Eater of Worlds. And the champion keeping to a methodical pace here. Just picking apart Heath Slater. I don't think Bray believes for a second that Slater's going to beat him. He wants to make an example of Slater. And of course, the man that beat Heath Slater at Money in the Bank 2016 was the challenger, the former two-time World Heavyweight Champion, Sheamus. Bray Wyatt looking to prove that he can do the very same thing, but Heath Slater trying to find a way back into this thing now after having found an opening. But Bray Wyatt, unbelievably quick for a man of his size, comes in and lays out Slater with those strikes, but Heath Slater comes back in. Bray Wyatt is having none of it. Look at that right hand, and now layout is probably more an appropriate term now, really, isn't it? Look at that big splash, 300 pounder crashing in to Heath Slater in the corner there. A big senton off the second rope from Bray Wyatt keeps the control firmly in his court. Bray Wyatt has seemed near enough untouchable. There's the Uranagi slam from Wyatt. Wyatt has seemed pretty much untouchable since cashing in Money in the Bank on Sheamus a number of weeks ago. And now a Bray Wyatt. There's the kiss of doom. Sister Abigail connects. Here's the cover from Bray Wyatt. There's 1, 2, 3. And that almost looked like it was bad wrestling etiquette for Bray Wyatt there. He pinned Heath Slater with Slater's face being barely an inch away from the ropes. But Wyatt was so confident that he'd won that match that he didn't care about ring placement. All he cared about was showing that when the time comes, he can do whatever he wants. that, ladies and gentlemen, is your World Heavyweight Champion. Bray Wyatt spelling it out for Sheamus then. Bray Wyatt stating pretty clearly, I will end you at Imperial Anarchy. We're moving on tonight though. This following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by Chaotic. From Maryville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 272 pounds, Kevin Owens. And now we see the extent of this forming partnership led by Shinsuke Nakamura, Kevin Owens, Dolph Ziggler, Bobby Roode, and Nakamura himself. We have still yet to ascertain why these four men have come together, especially Roode and Owens, who have formed their own little tag team in the middle of that. Of course, Kevin Owens and Bobby Roode will be taking on Blake and Murphy and Imperial Anarchy tonight. It's singles competition for the prize fighter. And his opponent from Stone Mountain, Georgia, Apollo Crews. The former hardcore champion in high spirits tonight. He's got a big fight on his hands though, as he takes on the former World Heavyweight Champion, Kevin Owens. Apollo looks confident as he walks down that ramp, but quite frankly, when does Apollo look anything different? A big win for Apollo Crews tonight. If he can get it, it will certainly start letting him climb towards another championship, possibly. And let's be honest, we've already seen, we've got two champions out there, but I was wrong, because we don't. We have seen the World Heavyweight Champion this evening asserting his dominance. We have the Patriot Champion stood at ringside right now. Three former World Heavyweight Champions in that group. That's quite an impressive statistic when you think about it. Because there's only been six champions. Half of the World Heavyweight Champions that have ever been a part of this fledgling group. Now look at that! Cannonball off the top there from Kevin Owens to start this thing off. He suckered in Apollo Crews and just laid him out in the first few seconds. Now look at Crews going big or going home. Electric chair lift there, but spins him in into a sit-out powerbomb. Here's the cover from Owens as 1, 2. Apollo Crews forced to kick out early on. Kevin Owens, he was just asserting himself there as the dominant leader of this matchup. As Crews tries to fight back, Kevin Owens has other plans. Owens springboards, Crews ducks out of the way. Owens goes flying over the top and crashes down, and this could be Apollo Crews' moment. Kevin Owens misses with the super kick wildly there, tries to take down Crews. Crews having none of it. Sends him crashing over the top with his own momentum now. Apollo Crews is out there after him, but Crews does have to be careful out there. He does not, and I repeat, does not want to find himself in the grasp of any of the other members of Chaotic. This thing could break down pretty quickly, and not in Apollo's favor. Apollo Crews back in the ring. Kevin Owens ascends the turnbuckle one more time. and for the second time lays out Apollo Crews with that cannonball off the top. Kevin Owens building in confidence right now as he takes it to Apollo Crews with those big strikes. Owens once again continuing to assert dominance. Goes for the cover one more time. There's only a 1.5 count this time from Kevin Owens. Apollo Crews still able to fight back without too much trouble. And now look at Crews trying to get back into this thing right now. Over the top there with a suplex from Apollo Crews. And now the former hardcore champion looks to be getting back into this thing. The man who says it's all too easy, baby. Would love an easy victory here tonight. And look at that over the head gut-wrench suplex. Now Crews in for the cover on Owens there. There's 1, 2. Kevin Owens kicks out at 2.5. Apollo Crews not happy about it. But that's the way it falls today. Now Apollo Crews going to work on Kevin Owens. Owens though has turned it around, is able to get Crews into the corner. You can see Dolph Ziggler, Bobby Roode in the background there, pretty pleased with how Kevin Owens has just turned this thing around. Owens gets him up on the top, using that top rope for an assisted driving DDT. And the former world champion is rolling in this one. Apollo Crews comes at him, but Kevin Owens there, quick as a hiccup, dumps him over the top with a back body drop. And look at that though, from Apollo Crews, just that speed, that quickness. Able to turn this thing around, get right back into the fight without too much fuss. Apollo Crews now in for the cover on Kevin Owens. Once again, there's 1, 2. Kevin Owens kicks out before the 2 count there. You can just see these two have given it all they've got. These two desperate to pick up this win tonight. Nobody wants to pick up a cheap victory. Nobody wants to take the loss. Kevin Owens there, able to fight back, and Nakamura's loving it, and there's the cannonball once again. Kevin Owens this time straight into the cover. There's 1, 2. Apollo Crews rolls the shoulder up, but Kevin Owens has certainly asserted the dominance here. Crews goes for that enziguri, that step up enziguri. Kevin Owens float over, DDT connects. Quite interesting to watch in the background as we go for the cover here. There's 1, 2, not quite even 2. Owens, every time Owens does something, you know, worthwhile, manages to drive Crews down into the mat. You see Nakamura and Roode react. You don't see Ziggler react very often. There's something to be said for the history between Kevin Owens and Dolph Ziggler there, of course, just as I'm saying it. 1 count there from Crews. Just as I'm saying that, of course. Dolph Ziggler decides to react, but yeah, I just can't. There's a pop-up powerbomb there from Kevin Owens. That came out of nowhere. I looked down for a moment there, and there was the pop-up powerbomb. There's 1, 2. No way Apollo Crews just rolled the shoulder up. No way, but he did. Crews dumped to the outside. Look at Kevin Owens there. Springboards off the top rope. Now Owens trying to fight back. See Owens there, stood the other side of the ring now as Apollo Crews gets back to his feet. Crews though, building that momentum up now. Crews feeling pretty good about himself. Kevin Owens does not want to count out loss here. That's an 8 count. Owens makes it in just in time, right in behind Apollo Crews, dragging him off that turnbuckle. And now Kevin Owens goes right in for it. But look at this from Apollo Crews. It looks like, despite all the odds, Apollo Crews could pull this one out of nowhere. Samoan drop. Standing moonsault. Crews rolling. Here's the cover. There's one, two, three. Kevin Owens, no, just about kicks out at the very last possible moment. Crews going to continue on the pressure though with that jumping elbow drop in the middle. Now it looks like Apollo Crews is going to try and end this with that spin out powerbomb of his. But Kevin Owens, no, wasn't going to have that. Now Kevin Owens drives the foot. There it goes, Apollo Crews. And once again, the pop-up powerbomb connects. There's one, two, three. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We'll take a look back at some of the highlights of this matchup, but all in all, that was a very competitive matchup between two incredible young athletes. But in the end, it's the former world champion who picks up a massive victory. And that gut wrench there almost sealed it for Apollo Crews out of nowhere. See, just back and forth, but this was the second pop-up powerbomb from Kevin Owens, and that one sealed the deal. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Kevin Owens. Massive win there for KO, exactly what he needed. There you see it, Imperial Anarchy, the glorious prize fighters will take on Blake and Murphy. Nakamura has his own problems in the Patriot title match. Ziggler will face Swagger. And then there's always HLRKO will face Ascension. John Cena made that challenge earlier on this evening. HLRKO will be facing the Ascension. Now we've got to move on to our main event this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from West Newbury, Massachusetts, weighing in at 252 pounds, he is one half of the CWR World Tag Team Champions, Mr. Hustle, Loyalty and Respect, John Cena! Cena made the challenge early this evening after he was interrupted by The Miz. Miz tried to walk away, and The Big Show was having none of it. He pretty much said to Miz, put your money where your mouth is. The one-on-one with the champ tonight. John Cena here, alone tonight, as we mentioned earlier, Randy Orton in the UK. For the promotional tour of Imperial Anarchy this Sunday. That belt will be on the line along with its brother as HLRKO defend against their chosen opponents, the Ascension. Slater's opponent this evening. Now residing in Hollywood, Florida, weighing in at 227 pounds, the A-lister, The Miz. Former hardcore champion is here. The A-lister has been rather absent as of late, ever since losing that hardcore championship to Apollo Crews. But tonight, The Miz looks to make a big, big impact as he takes on one half of the World Tag Team Champions. A big victory could be all it takes to revitalize The Miz's career and get him right back on track here in The Revolution. Have the two men that'll be competing one-on-one, no outside interference, no tag team partners, no nothing. This is your traditional one-fall match. Have a look at that immediately. Miz tries to lock up with Cena, and Cena makes him pay, but Miz puts on a head of steam there. Turns it into a neck breaker, but look at John Cena there with that carry takeover. Straight away, Miz is looking to gain some kind of retribution for being placed into this match against his will. He's looking to build some momentum to try and put himself back on the map. John Cena tonight is out there with the intention of building momentum towards his championship defense at the pay-per-view this coming Sunday, live from London, England. The Miz straight away relying on old tactics, going after that turnbuckle post, but look at Cena with that hurricanrana. Miz now, though, has control off the ropes, and a big boot to the face there from the A-lister. Over the top, though, goes Miz. He does have to be careful. Cena definitely has the power advantage in this one. Cena usually has the power advantage in any match he's in. But the Miz knows that. Of course, they are old rivals back in the day, Miz and Cena. They know each other quite well. There's a big elbow around the ringer many, many times with these men. Miz there with that inverted DDT. And now Miz unusually going to the top rope, but you got to do what you got to do in a situation like this. And Miz cross body block, but look at Cena there, catches him. And just a rib breaker there. Catches him in midair. Absolutely sheer strength. Impressive strength there from John Cena in that moment. Miz trying to fight back, but Cena has a counter for it. It seems that no matter what Miz does right now, John Cena is all over this one. Hurricanrana once again. From the leader of the C Nation, we've got the cover here. There's one. Miz able to kick out. John Cena looks to end this one early now. You can't see me. Five knuckle shuffle connects. And as we all know, Cena usually follows up the five knuckle shuffle with his signature AA cover. One, two, Miz able to pop that shoulder up. You saw there, Cena didn't have the cover as flush as he would have liked it. Miz was able to just kind of roll that shoulder up, and it was enough to break the count. But look at that though, Miz, he exposed that turnbuckle at the beginning of this matchup, and he's just had it come back and bite him as Cena sent him crashing back first into the steel. Miz trying to get back into this thing now with that Dragon Whip. The A-lister picking his mark. But look at that, Cena just snaps him. Miz just not quite in his element there, not quite in his game, and Cena just snaps it, takes the opportunity, and now Miz is in trouble. This is bad news for the A-lister off the top there. Back suplex off the top, and Cena, you can see, hurt himself with such a fall, but it was worth it just to drive Miz into the mat. And now John Cena, what's he got planned? Follows it up with an elbow right to the chest, and you can see Cena attacking the entire midsectional area, which is kind of what you would expect considering that AA finisher wants to wear down the back, but it also does help to put some pressure on those ribs, on those abdominal muscles. Miz needs to slow this pace down. That's exactly what he's doing right now. But as usual, Miz getting a little bit too cocky, wasting a little bit too much time in my eyes. Maybe not though. Drives the knee into the shoulder blade, and there's the combination from the Miz. Neck breaker, and now Miz looking to finish this off with the scroll, that too. Skull crushing, no, he's going for the figure four, but Cena is incredibly close to those ropes. John Cena does not give up easy, and that was the mistake. He turns it around, just John Cena reverses the pressure of the Miz, now scurried out of the move to protect his own legs. That was a mistake, going for a submission move on Cena. We all know that, and once again, that turnbuckle plays dividend, driving into the back of the Miz. Cena into the opposite corner, well, the adjacent corner, technically. Now Cena, single arm suplex there over the top. Single arm hooked, you know what I mean. Miz, though, still trying to fight back, still sees his openings. And there we go with that. What? I wouldn't even know what to call that move, but it certainly looked like it hurt. There's the cover here from the Miz. There's one, two. Cena now on the defensive. Miz in prime position to pick up a big win, but look at Cena, just tips him up there. Double leg takedown, and the leader of the C Nation is back in control. And once again, Cena, arm in the air, you can't see me. Bada boom, five knuckle shuffle, and Cena, tried and tested methodology here, up onto the shoulders for the second time in this match. AA connects. There's one, two, three. Can't say the Miz didn't put up a fight tonight, because he certainly did. There were points where it looked like Miz was going to take this thing home, but a few mistakes made, and John Cena took full advantage of the situation. Where Miz, I thought we were going to turn it around there with that combination neckbreaker. We went for the figure four, and that was the mistake, as Cena was able to turn the pressure around. If Miz had hit the skull-crushing finale in that moment, who knows what could have happened in the end. But as it stands, the AA for the second time in this matchup. Cena right into the cover this time. Extra pressure on that other shoulder of the Miz. And Miz had nothing left. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner. One half of the CWR Tag Team Champions, John Cena. With that momentum builder going into this Sunday, you got to think HLRKO are feeling pretty damn good. Don't forget to join us, of course, this Sunday live right here on this channel for the Imperial Anarchy pay-per-view, where you'll see not only that tag team championship defense, you will see Dolph Ziggler take on Jack Swagger. You will see the glorious Prizefighters take on Blake and Murphy. Shinsuke Nakamura will be defending the Patriot title in a triple threat match. And of course, Bray Wyatt will be defending the World Heavyweight Championship against Sheamus. But ladies and gentlemen, for now, that was CWR Asylum. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. And we'll see you tomorrow for Horizon. Take care and keep it sweet.